At 30 years old, the Barcelona right back has just won the Confederations Cup, which was played in Brazil a year before the World Cup.
La gran mayoría, yo pienso que
well, I believe
si
most people
que apostar ahora por
of
la selección
the world
brasileña,
would bet on Brazil's chances, but three or four months before, I think they wouldn't have bet on our team.
Meses,
that shows how important, really,
la gran mayoría,
the Confederations Cup
no? Entonces,
had for the
es
perception of our team.
Que ha tenido para nosotros la Copa de las Confederaciones.
During the Confederations Cup, more than a million people were protesting every day across the country over social matters. But as the protests continued in the streets outside, the Seleção managed to capture a mood of optimism. Yes, a dream to play in the World Cup and a Confederations Cup in front of your own supporters, our families, and the people who really appreciate you.
You
cannot put a price on that. When the Brazilian national team enters the pitch, people forget about everything. They love the Seleção, they have an amazing relationship with the team, and they're able to put aside their problems for a while. Having the possibility to bring that joy to the public, especially with all the problems we had in the Confederations Cup, it was wonderful. Beating European and world champion Spain 3-0 in the final showed the value of this Seleção after all the criticism of the national team since the 2010 World Cup. It helped us show that we're candidates to win the World Cup. It seems that people have forgotten about Brazil as a national team. It's a team that's won five World Cups, so you can never write us off. But we can't think that it's all done and dusted. The World Cup will be completely different to the Confederations Cup. And of course, I had the experience with a negative ending in 2010. Danny was part of the team eliminated in the quarterfinals in the World Cup in South Africa, but this time playing at home can make a big difference, even if Brazil do have bad memories from the 1950 World Cup against Uruguay. Well, for us, it's wonderful. It'll be very special. We have a unique goal. Change the picture of the World Cup in Brazil and of the Maracanã. That's our main goal. We want the Maracanã to be remembered as the place where a great Brazilian national team entered their name in history. He's referring, of course, to that famous loss in the 1950 match against Uruguay.
That
saw Brazil fail to win the World Cup when they last hosted it. The arrival of Philip Scolari, who substituted former coach Mano Menezes, has given confidence to the Seleção. He brought his experience of the World Cup win in 2002 to the young Brazilian team.
They're phenomenal
playing football. You need to have somebody directing you, telling you where to go, and where not to go, how to do things. I believe that before, unfortunately, we didn't have this kind of person.
Esta persona
can represent you and make you have the respect of the other teams. Now people look at our bench and say, there he is, a world champion. Brazil can also count on the talent of young star Neymar, who's just signed for Barcelona. He can improve his game alongside his teammate Dani Alves. I believe Neymar is one of the few players
who,
when he was born, God touched him and gave him a gift, saying, you will be the player. Barca is a great team with really good players, but the world of football will be focused on him. He will be exposed, and the world will start to know him better.
Atento a lo que suceda, va a estar
they will see who Neymar really
el mundo entero va a empezar a conocerlo.
And exactly what he's
quién
able
es realmente
to do.
Él, de lo que capaz de hacer.
Well, that's it for now, though, from our special guest, Dani Alves.